In the land of the multitude of mosquitoes. So as you can clearly see, we've both come out perfectly dressed to do bushcraft in a mosquito-ridden area. So we've got I've got a pair of like boating shoes and a pair of short socks and shorts. So we've got plenty of exposed skin, ideal for the mosquitoes to bite us. Because we're really considerate when we do our bushcraft. You know, we're going to take something away from the environment. You know, by building fires and shelters, using the wood that's here. But we probably need to give something back. We do that by donating blood to mosquitoes.
We're like the Red Cross that way.
So, carving feather sticks. What we'll do, I'll just demonstrate it briefly on here, and then I'll have to zoom the camera in so you can see exactly what we're doing. With the convex edges, obviously I need to be careful. I'm sitting on a tree stump here. To get us lower to the ground to make it easier for insects to get to us. You know, we're just thoughtful all the time. I need to be aware when I'm working, obviously I'm not going to cut myself, so I'm working away from my body. With a convex edge, the beauty of it is you can very slightly, by twisting your wrist, you can control how much or how deeply you're cutting under the wood, which means you're able to take off literally very, very hair thin layers. Now, I haven't bothered splitting this log. Normally what I do is split the log and work off a sharp edge, and I haven't bothered here just because I can't be bothered, because it's too hot to do any sort of strenuous work. But so very easily I can hold the knife and slide down the work, okay, and you get coils. Now we'll have to get a nice flat piece of wood for me to work off. That's what I want to do here first. Nice grain, and you can see how much it's curling up because you can control the edge really easily. So I can come in here and I can get really deep curls, and then by leaning backwards on the blade very slightly, I can shave these much, much finer and bring these curls off almost hair fine. What I'll probably do is just bring these over to the camera, actually, rather than try and reposition the camera. I'll just bring these to the camera. Do you know what? This is nice. There could be a spoon in here.
Knowing you, there probably is.
The wood's a bit rotten. It's a bit soft, but I'll just show these first few that I've just done here. Okay, so I'm just going to show you the few that we've got here. Okay, you can see how fine and how tight the curls go. Now, I favour a convex edge. I find it really hard to do exactly this fine with a Scandi or a flat ground. When you're carving your feathers, though, if you keep the blade dead straight, okay, and you push down straight, the curls will go straight. Like that, they'll go roughly in a straight line and keep them nice and tight. If you tilt the blade down and carve your feathers, the feathers will go to the left, as you can see, and you'll get like a spiral out of them. I'm going to cut them deep so you can see them, okay? Oh, gone too deep there. Oh, it's really rotten on the inside, look. I've gone on the side here where it's not quite so rotten. And you'll see the feathers will go off to the left. If I tilt the blade up and do the same thing, the feathers curl over to the right. So when you're carving your feather sticks, if you change the direction of going down, going up and going straight, I'm probably going to open this up and find there's going to be something inside that's going to bite me, because whatever it is, it's certainly eating into this wood. You can create a big fan of feathers. And you start with the big feathers to start with, and then you gradually get them finer and finer until you get right down to really tight feathers, but really like almost hair thin feathers. Put a spark into that and you've got yourself a fire. You know, I actually do use feather sticks an awful lot for fire lighting, because they're quick, they're convenient, they're easy. If you find any sort of half decent dead wood, you can get to dry wood inside it. And it's just a quick way, you know, that takes very little processing to do. So I do use feather sticks a lot. But I think having this this thin blade, because it's only a 3mm blade, and it's fully tapered down to a convex bevel, making it very thin at the blade edge. And I think that also works for doing these feather sticks.
again, that goes back to what I was saying about how with the Scandi, it tends to tear into it. So I always end up with very thick feathers on my feather stick. I'm still working on my technique, still adjusting to the convex, but they are getting thinner because I have better control of being able to keep those things thinner. It's not digging in the way my Scandi does, and it's good results, man. This is a great knife.
One other beauty of this knife as well. This is my actual one, okay? Although I've said on videos I'm left-handed, I am ambidextrous and I do use both hands equally. But this edge on this is a really sharp edge, and it's really good for striking on the ferro rod, okay? The ball bearing steel and another one called silver steel are extremely good for doing this. So I can strike with this and get really good sparks. But this knife is also a bit of a joke knife, because if I give my knife to Dave, in your right hand, because you're right-handed, aren't you?
I am.
And strike my ferro rod the same way. You see? So, I use this quite a lot, because it's been ground one way, for me.
Oh!
Check your one.
Bugger!
Just check your one.
No, mine's the same way. I would need to use it left-handed to get a good bite. You know? But if I use it right-handed, I'm up a creek. I'm absolutely up a creek.
I can fix it while I'm here.
All right, no worries.
But it's quite amusing that, you know, when I take people out and I light a fire with it, and I'm giving my knife a light of fire, and they can't even get a spark. What are you doing? So. But that just amuses me. Right, listen, thanks, guys. It's a really short video, as you can say. We've just moved on. We've just mentioned the feather sticks in the first video. We thought we'd quickly make a bit of a hash of a video on feather sticks for you. When I can find an area that has proper wood, you know. But I'll do a more in-depth video on actual feather sticks and actually lighting fires with them. Because we're not lighting fires here, we're in a state park.
State park.
So we're not lighting fires up here today. Yep.
All right.
Excellent. Thanks for watching.
Cheers.
God, listen to the crickets.
Yeah.
We bought our own orchestra.
We did. Yeah, look at this, man. Mine are still coming off a little thick, but that's better than it ever was before with the Scandi.
You just need to...
need to work on my control.
Yeah, I mean, you've got a sharp edge here, right? Just lay it on there and be really gentle, okay? Don't push too hard. Because the reason they're thick is because you're putting a lot of effort into it.
Right.
If you don't put any effort into it, if I went in deep, right, if you don't put any effort into it, I can't move the blade. So now I've then got to tilt the blade back until I get an edge where it's gentle. So move the blade nice and gently and work off the edges. What I'll find is I'll go to this corner here, and now I've got an edge there and I've got an edge here. So I can come to this edge and carve this one. Then I can go to this edge and carve this one.
Nice.
Now I've got an edge there and carve that edge, go back to that edge. And you go around like a clock, all right? And that's the secret of doing feathers, is you're working off the facets. You can see them?
Yep.
So if you try and use your knife and try and take one, two, three. But be gentle with the knife. You only wanted to touch it.
Aha.
Yeah, and obviously it's a short stick. If that was a longer stick, you'd get, look how many curls, it's curling, you're getting the curls in it.
Yeah, and you're right, there's really no effort.
If you do the effort, if you do the effort, it's when you get the deep ones. But you want the deep ones initially to start. Or you could have one stick of just thick ones if you wanted to, and then cover the thin ones into the others. But I generally do pick the whole range on all sticks.
Yeah, I see what you're talking about.
Excuse me, we're making a video here.
Those crickets are loud.
Crickets and locusts. If only they knew who I was, they'd be making so much noise now, would they? If only they knew.
Maybe they do, that's why they're singing for you.
Well, maybe. Or maybe it's good having a bit of anonymity.
Anonymity, yeah.
Anonymity.
Anonymity. Hamna. Yeah, those are pretty small now. Okay, I see.
You could light that.
Yeah, I reckon I could.
The flame wouldn't last very long.
No.
There's nothing for it to burn, but you could light that.
Reckon I could. That'd probably take a spark from a ferro rod, huh?
Mm-hmm. That's fine.
Yeah, those are nice and thin. good knife, man. So sharp. Just goes through this like butter.
So we will fix the grind on the back of that.
Sweet. That'll be awesome.
To make it for you cacani people.
Well, you know what they say, left-handed people are the only people in their right mind.
Ah, very good, very good. See, we can cover philosophy and theology.
If love is blind and God is love and Ray Charles is blind. No, I got that order wrong. If God is love and love is blind and Ray Charles is blind, is Ray Charles God?
Some people may agree with you on that.
I think so. Or is it Stevie Wonder? He's also blind.
Right. So is it any blind person?
You know, that's a good question.
Because we have David Blunkett back in the UK. And okay. He definitely isn't God. He definitely isn't. At least not my God.
He's not your God, huh?
No, for sure.
No. Oh, man. You know, what I was talking about with this thing going in and out real easy in a thicker piece, when I was doing that spoon, for instance, mm-hmm. when I was using a Scandi, even if I dug in like that, I had no chance of coming back out. But look at how fast I can come out with this. Mm. You know, it's just, you just spoon it right out, you know? And, you know, I really like that about this knife. I don't get stuck, you know, with a Scandi, I'd be like, and there was no choice but to turn around and come from the other side. I would obviously turn my work around, not come at my femoral artery right here, you know, with a knife, but yeah, it just spoons right out. I love that about this knife. It's just a better grind. See, now I really do need to come from the other side at this point. But
let me show you a technique that a lot of wood carvers use. Personally, I don't use it that much. To come towards you, what they'll do. That's got so many other things living in it. I'd rather not use that.
And here, use this.
Just concerned about getting
bit up.
Well, finding there's a, I don't know, something that's going to bite me.
Oh, yeah, hang on, there's something that's going to bite you there. Oh, where'd he go?
There he is.
Oh, it's the earwig.
We get him in the UK.
I know, he was moving so fast I couldn't see him.
So if you're working towards yourself, you need to have control. What you can do is you place the work on your work, uh-huh. the knife on your work, and it's these fingers that are doing all the pulling.
I see.
Okay, so for the camera can see, hopefully. So it's these fingers here that are doing the pulling. So I'm holding the work my left hand. Right hand, sorry. Put the work in. The knife is, my left hand is only holding the work. My three fingers here are pushing the blade. Now what it means, I can't come too far because my fingers have only got a certain amount of draw. Mm. So all my work, I'm pushing with my fingers. And I'll never slip and come right down here because mm-hmm. my fingers can't get that far. So if you have got to come towards yourself, it's a fairly safe way of controlling your cuts when you're coming towards yourself.
Brilliant.
All right, because it gives you a limited range of motion. Obviously, it's best not to, if you possibly can, not cut towards yourself, but...
It's a nice piece of wood.
Do you know what it is?
No, but there might be a spoon in it.
Is it tree wood, I think?
Tree wood?
I think it is.
I'd say so, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It looks like a tree wood to me, does it?
I prefer tree wood, you know.
Yeah.
There's other kinds of wood.
There is. for carving.
For carving, yeah, you don't want to carve that.
So, just for the record, okay, you know, Dave and I, good for our, you know, enthusiasts, let's say, we've come, you know, using our years of experience and, you know, lots of, you know, studying in textbooks and stuff, we've determined that this is definitely tree wood.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Absolutely. Not the other kind.
No.
All right, so I'm holding the work like so, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, and then I'm using...
It's these three fingers.
These three fingers, oh. Yes, these three fingers, okay.
Yeah, and you just push.
I see.
It's not a powerful cut, but if you need to sort of do shaving.
Well, that's what I'm getting. I'm getting little bits. There we go.
But you said you wanted to come back and just cut the pieces you cut off.
Right, so I would want little pieces anyway.
You know, sometimes when you're carving a spoon, you know, when you're doing the shoulders, sometimes you just want to just shave that little bit off, and you'd use this technique for doing that.
Okay. Like, I know how to rock it forward like so.
Yeah.
And I get nice shavings that way, but... But yeah, doing it backwards towards the work, that's a really good technique, Sean. So make sure you keep your thumb out of the way.
It's just a safe way. I mean, if you reduce the amount of movement you have towards yourself.
Right. Also, I'm thinking, you know, because right now I'm holding this work between my legs, and I'm not worried one bit about cutting my legs.
normally I wouldn't hold work between my legs because I run some risks.
Same as myself, I wouldn't.
Right. But like this, I know that I've only got this little range of motion here, so no fear. Well, yeah, that's a good technique.
I was shown that technique by John Mack, who's a spoon carver, a friend of mine down in Dartmoor in England.
Okay.
And he showed me the technique, and it took me a while to get the hang of it. I found it really cack-handed, but you know, once you get the hang of it, you realise actually, because it's such a safe motion.
Yeah.
Once you can get the hang of it, it comes almost a second nature then.
Yeah. Look how they just come right out of that. Just, I love that. Such a good knife.
That doesn't have a nice grain, and that sportiness in there as well.
Yeah, I'm seeing that.
Maybe we could. Have you got a saw here? I didn't pack one of mine.
I didn't pack a saw.
Maybe we could take it home and carve something out of it.
We can get this in the car. Yeah, it's all right, man. I'm digging this knife. Yeah, this is gonna go in the car. You heard it here, folks.
But maybe cool. But maybe not in the edit.
But maybe not in the edit. Cool, man. I think we got